ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति 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 शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं वादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवत् व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ शांति शांति शांति। वर्ष नंबर 121 सर्व प्रकार प्रमिति प्रशांति ही बीजात्मनावस्थितिरेव बुद्धे सुसुप्तिरे तस्य किल प्रतीति ही किंचिन्न वेद्मीति जगत प्रसिद्धे। आई चांट वन मोर टाइम। सर्व प्रकार प्रमिति प्रशांति बीजात्मनावस्थितिरेव बुद्धे सुषुप्तिरे तस्य किल प्रतीति ही किंचिन्न वेद्मी इति जगत प्रसिद्धि। The translation is, the mind remain in a subtle seed-like form in deep sleep, which the state of complete cessation of the all kind of perceptions. Indeed, the universal experience in this state is, I did not know anything. So this is the verse. Before we enter in this verse, I would like to share some other thoughts. Actually, we have studied about three gunas, and we know what effect has these gunas in our life. They have lots of effect in our life. They control our all life. They control our all life, our all activity, our thinking. Everything is in control of the gunas. So there is a question. Is there any way we should control the gunas? Can we control the gunas? Scripture says yes. That is the spiritual practice. This is true. Gunas control our life. This is natural life. This is the worldly life. What if we want to control our gunas? There is a way. Our all thoughts are somewhere rooted. There is no any original thought. Their root may be in society, their root may be in scriptures, their root may be in family. So all gunas have their roots. If we thread these roots, then you can control the gunas. In our scriptures, there are 10 facts, 10 reasons. If you collect them, if you follow them properly, then you can control your gunas. It is up to you what guna you want. So there are 10 facts, 10 things. I explain them one by one and carefully. Listen, and you can note down us. The first thing is study. Then comes water, company, place, time, activity, birth, meditation, chanting, impressions. Let us understand what are they. The first thing is study. If you want to increase your Shatguna, you should have study a religious book, a great master's autobiography, scriptures like Gita, Upanishad. Just read. Make a habit. If you want to create Rajoguna, read newspaper, magazine, the worldly news, then you automatically your Rajoguna will increase. And for Tamoguna, you can read different type studies. So study makes much difference in your thought. Study makes make difference in your thought process. So first thing is study. If you want to sattvic thought, spiritual thought, you must read spiritual books. So first thing is study. Another is water. Water means whatever we drink. The drinking, like water, also make the effect in our life, our thought. If your drinking is pure, sattvic, with sattvaguna, then sattvaguna will increase. If drinking is rajas, then it will increase rajoguna and another tamoguna. Then comes companion. What is your company? How type people are surrounding you? Your surrounding, your friends. If your friends are spiritual, sattvic, then your automatically thought will come sattvic. So third thing is company, your society, your family. Another is place. Place, where you are living, where you are studying, where you are going, where you are sitting, the place makes much difference. If you are in like Himalaya, thought will come pure. If you are in marketplace, there is so much crowd, automatically thoughts will come in rajas. So place makes much difference in our life. So choose place. If you want, the sattvic thought will come in your mind. You choose sattvic place. Like bank of the river, mountains, temples, sacred places, they will increase your sattva-guna. So place also make much effect in your thought process. Then comes time. Time. If there is a morning time, then automatically your thought starts sattvic. Your mind becomes quiet. If time is evening, in Sanskrit we call it Rakshas Vela, evil time. Your thought, without any acting, without any doing, thought will come, Tamas. So time also make effect in our life. Then comes activity. Activity. What kind of activity you are doing right now? You are doing charity. You are helping other people. You are a kind person. So then your sattva guna will increase. Day-to-day activity in your life also is a seed for thought. So correct your activity. So make correction your activity. Unless if you want, what kind guna you want? If you want rajas, then do activity search. If you want tamas, do activity search. If you want sattvic, then do activity like sattvic. Then comes birth. Birth means atmosphere of the family, the people, your body structure, your habits. So birth also, your body structure, also make a difference in your life. Birth. Then comes meditation. Meditation. We meditate. If you are a spiritual seeker, obviously you are meditating. But what object is for your meditation? What is the object? If object is sattvic, like a deity, a god, if meditation object is like a ghost, then thought becomes tamas. So meditation point, it does not mean you are meditating, that is your sattvic. Your meditation, the object is. That is why there are very difference in Patanjali and Vedanta. Patanjali always says, you meditate anywhere. Object does not have meaning. You meditate anywhere. You may meditate on stone, stars, river, anywhere, flower, anywhere. Anything, any object you can take for meditation, it is okay for Patanjali. Because his intention is concentration of the mind, not your object. But in Vedanta, object has its meaning. Object leaves its effect in your mind. So it is not matter for concentration. Its matter is effect in your life. So Patanjali says, it is not matter for object. You meditate wherever you want. It may be flower, river, stars, any human being. Anything you can take, because he wants only concentration. He wants only concentration, not else. But in Vedanta, he says, no. The point of the meditation also affect your thought, your life. If you are thinking about God, about a great person, then your thought will become like this. If you are thinking about a ghost, about a devil, about the evil thing, this also will make effect in your thought process. Concentration may be, but in effect your life becomes tamas. So meditation also is one thing. Then comes chanting. Chanting is japa. You chant a mantra. So there are three types of mantra. One mantra is sattvic, rajas and tamas. So up to you, what kind of mantra you are chanting. If your mantra is rajas, then your thought would be rajas. If your mantra is sattvic, your thought will be sattvic. Your mantra is tamas, then thought process will go towards tamas. That is why Lord Sri Krishna says in Gita, Yanti dev vrta devan pitrin yanti pitri vrta bhutan yanti bhutejya yanti madhya jinupima. So, all ways are open for you. Chanting, then comes impression. Impression means our past lives and this life's bad and good actions effect, which is stored in our antakara. Our past lives and we did in this life also, these good or bad effects are stored in our inner instrument. They call impression. They are very strong. They are very strong. So these 10 regions, they are very effective to control your thought process. To make your thought sattvic, you make your thought tamas or rajas. See, you cannot blame that. We cannot do anything because everything is doing guna. I'm not doer. You can control your gunas. And the process is, first, you control your rajas and tamas, increasing by sattvaguna. Then you control your sattvaguna also using by subtle sattvaguna. Subtle sattvaguna. So these 10 reasons we have for spiritual practice. You use your life, then you can control your guna. You can increase your sattva-guna. You can decrease your rajoguna and tamoguna. So up to you. That is meaning of the spiritual practice. Otherwise, there is no meaning of spiritual practice. If we cannot do, we are the puppet in the hand of the gunas, then what does it mean of the spiritual practice? So spiritual practice means the 10 facts. You read properly. You're reading, I repeat again, you're reading, you're drinking, plus eating, your food. Drinking does not mean only water, your food, what kind of food you have. So food will also make. So your study, your drinking and eating, your company, your place, time, activity, birth, meditation, chanting, impressions. So these 10 things are which can control your guna process. Now, we are entering today's topic, Sarva Prakar Prashamiti Prashanti Bija Mana. I translate one more time. Profound sleep is the cessation of all kind of perception in which the mind remains in a settled seed-like form. The test of this is the universal verdict that I did not know anything then. Do you remember that in last verse, there is a last line, and pralina sarvendriya buddhi vritti. Pralina sarvendriya buddhi vritti means in which all the functions of the mind, intellect and the sense of organs are totally suspended. So this verse is explaining the last line of the previous verse. What Sushupti is? The question is, what Sushupti is? What the definition of the Sushupti? Deep sleep. We know waking state, everyone knows. We know dream state, everyone knows. No proof required. No logic required. So clear. Everyone knows. What about Sushupti, deep sleep? What the proof? So Shankaracharya explains, Sarva Prakara Prashamiti Prashanti. To understand Sushupti, the deep sleep, first we know waking state. Waking state, there is object or gross. And you experience through mind and your actions, your mind and sense of perceptions. So this is the state of waking. In dream state, objects are subtle and you experience only through mind. So in both states, there is knowing. I know this, I know that, I know you, this, that. And in dream also, same process. You knowing, you know this, that, good, bad, everything. What about Sushupti? Shankaracharya says, Sarva Prakara Prashamiti. In deep sleep, there is no knowing. No knowing. No subtle, no gross. Now the question arises, if in deep sleep everything becomes ceased, mind is not working, then what about next day? When we wake up in the morning and we lost everything, Shankaracharya says no. When you will wake up, everything will be in your minds. Bijat panavastitireva buddhe. In susupti, deep sleep, the mind is not working. Intellect is not working, but mind is there. In bijatmana. Bijatmana means in seed form. Like a seed. You see a seed, very little. A banyan tree seed. You can break it. But nothing, you will find anything. No color, no juice, no smell, no taste. But everything is there. There are colors, there are fruits, taste, everything. So seed has everything, but we are not able to see. So this state is state called seed. In susupti, bijat panavastitireva buddhe, Shankaracharya says, that time in deep sleep, your mind, your intellect is in seed form. Everything is there. So don't worry. You will forget everything. You will forget your house, your bank balance. So don't worry. When you will wake up, everything will come to your mind. Susupti retasya kila pratiti. So this is the state of susupti, deep sleep. This is the definition of this. Definition of the deep sleep. There is no any knowledge. No good knowledge, no bad knowledge, no illusion, no clarity. Nothing. No knowledge. Susupti retasya kila pratiti. Then how do we know? This is susupti, and Shankaracharya says, kinchin na vedmiti jagat prasiddhe. In susupti, in deep sleep, our all knowledge, it may be first hand knowledge, inference, etc., they become ceased. There is no knowledge. But experiencer is there. Objects also there. You have experience, you are there. Experiencer is there. Objects are there. But there is no knowledge. Because there is no instrument. There is no device. Like a person is blind or he closed his eyes. Person is blind or you close your eyes. Everything is there. You have capability to see. Objects are also there, but knowledge not happening because eyes do not work, device do not work. Open your eyes, you can see. Same, in deep sleep, experiencer is there. Objects are also there. But our device is not working. So, we have no knowledge. When we wake up in the morning, everyone say the same experience. Everyone say the same experience. I did not know anything. I had so good sleep. I had so good sleep. 4 or 5 hours, where has gone? I don't know. So knowledge is I know. I know this, I know, I know, I know. This is knowledge. I do not know. This is not knowing. Jagat Prasiddhe Shankaracharya, everyone. This is universal verdict. This is universal verdict. Everyone have same experience. I had so good sleep. I had so deep sleep. So relaxed, so enjoyable. I did not know anything. I did not know anything. So it means pralin kinchinna vedmiti jagat prasiddhe. The universal verdict is everyone have experience. I had good sleep. I did not know anything. So this is the proof of Sushupti. Now next one. Verse number 122. Dehendriya prana manu hamadaya sarve vikara visaya sukhadaya vyomadi bhutan nakhilam cha vishvam abhyakta pariyantam idam hi anatma. I repeat. Dehendriya prana manu ahamadaya sarve vikara visaya sukhadaya vyomadi bhutan nakhilam cha vishvam abhyakta pariyantam idam hi anatma. The translation is the body, sense organs, pranas, mind and ego, etc. and all their modifications, the sense objects and their pleasures, etc., the gross elements such as ether, etc., the whole universe up to the unmanifest, these constitute the not-self. I repeat one more time the translation. The body, sense organs, pranas, mind and ego, etc., and all their modifications, the sense objects and their pleasures, etc., the gross elements such as ether, etc., the whole universe up to the unmanifest, these constitute the not-self. If you remember that, the topic was started about anatma, not self. What is not self? When the disciple reached to Guru, the master, and dialogue started, so Guru said, first you know what is not self. In scriptures, there are two ways to indicate the Brahman. Indicate. One is negation, neglect. Another is affirmation. So first, you understand whatever you know, whatever you see, whatever you understand. You try to find out, are they Brahman or not? So Guru started this topic and this process. He told about gross body, subtle body, and causal body, three gunas, everything. And now the conclusion comes. The guru has no interest to describe body. He was not a doctor. He had no interest in body. He was not a psychologist to describe the mind. His purpose was describing body, describing mind, describing inner instruments to know its them reality. What are they? What is their reality? That is why he described. Now, after that description, so Guru now says, not self. Dehe Indriya, you know the body? Disciple says, yes, I know. Then Guru said, this, the body is not Atma. You know the body, not superficial level, deeply, how body has come into existence. So Guru explained everything. So Guru said, do you know body? He says, yes. I know body. The master says, this body is not Atma. Not Atma. Then comes Indriya. Indriya. The organ of perception, organ of actions. They are subtler than body. They are subtler than body. So Guru says, no, these are also not self. Dehi Indriya. Then comes Prana. Prana more subtler. More subtler than organs. Prana is like life force. So Guru says, no, I have described about Prana. Prana is not self. You know about prana. Prana is also not self. Then comes mano, mind, thought process. This is much subtler. So Guru says, no, this is also not prana, and not self. Ahamadaya, then ahanka, ego. We discussed in deeply these matters. So Guru said, ahanka, the ego, I-ness. Do you remember that? I-ness. I-ness also is not self. Sarve vikara vishaya sukhadeva. So these all are not self. So first, you know what self not. Then comes sarve vikara vishaya. Their modifications. Their modifications. Vikara means modifications. Like milk turned into curd, yogurt. Sarve vikara, all modifications, the objects, sukhadeya, happiness, miseries, anger, greediness, these all are so not consciousness. And vyomadi bhutani, now things goes much deeper. Now still we are thinking about individual level. still our thought process was in individual level. Now it becomes collective. Vyomani Bhutani, the five elements, the five great elements, they may be subtle or gross, they are also not consciousness, they are also not self. And Akhilam cha Vishwam, the whole universe, it may be in front of you, it may be far away, in other galaxies, in other planets, we are not able to know them, but they exist in our other solar system, in other galaxies. There may be life, there may be things. Akhilam cha Vishwam, the whole universe, you know or you not? Akhilam cha Vishwam, these are not shown. And avyakta paryantam, up to avyakta. Avyakta means not visible. So here he divides in two parts. One is visible. It may be in our planets. It may be in another planets. But it is visible. It is visible. And there are some things, some facts, they are not visible. Avyakta. We cannot see. Actually, their nature is not visible. So, how can you try? You try any way, whatever you use, but their nature is not visible. We cannot see them. So, it is Maya. Avyakta, up to Maya. Up to Maya. Everything. So, repeat the one more time. Start from body. Body is not self. Then organs also not self. Then pranas also not self. Mind also not self. Ego also not self. And then happiness, miseries. Then cosmos, the subtle and gross five elements also not self. And all universe, make clear decision, these are not self. Up to Maya. I remember Tulsidas has written very clearly and very simple way. Very simple way. He said, whichever you can see, whichever you can imagine, these are not consciousness. Idam here Atma, Shankaracharya said, these all are not self. Very clearly. Now, next one. Maya, Maya Karyam, Saravam Mahadadi Deha Pariyantam, Asat Idam Anatma Tattvam, Vidhitam Maru Marichika Kalpam. I repeat. Maya, Maya Karyam, Saravam Mahadadi Deha Pariyantam, Asat Idam Anatmattvam, Vidhitam Maru Marichika Kalpam. The meaning is, everything is due to the effect of Maya, from Mahat down to the gross body. Know you that these and Maya itself are the not-self, therefore they are unreal, like the mirage, water in desert. I repeat one more time the translation. Everything is due to the effect of Maya. From Mahat down to the gross body, know thou that these, the Maya itself, are the not self, therefore they are unreal, like the mirage, water in desert. The same thing, whichever is explained in previous verse, in reverse order. In reverse order, same thing has been said here. Now start from Maya. In previous verse, he started from the gross body up to Maya. Now he started from the Maya. Maya is not Brahman. The first thing is, Maya is not Brahman. And its effect. If Maya is not Brahman, then its effect. So everything is its effect. And it is from Mahadadi. The very first is Mahat. Very first thing is Mahat. So in the very beginning, you can say that this way, once upon a time, there was no time. Only Brahman was alone. Ekamev Adityam. He was alone without second. And he thought, I became so many. Bahu Shyam Prajaya. He thought, I became Bahu. So many. So this is the first thought. Then Mahat. And the universe started, Mahadadi, and it slowly, slowly, one by one, came still gross body, up to gross body. Gross body is the last creation. Started from the Maya. Mahadadi Deha Pariyantam. So creation is from the Mahat. And it is until gross body. So gross body is last creation. Not only your gross body. Whatever you are watching, whatever you are watching, everything is gross body. It may be planet, plants, it may be animal, creature. All is gross body. Mahadadi Deha Pariyantam. Now, conclusion comes. Asat Idam Anatma Tattum. So, conclusion is, these are Asat. They have no existence. They appear without existence. So, he gave example, very famous, very classical example in Vedanta. Maru Marichika Kalpam. Like the mirage water in the desert. Mirage water in the desert. When we go in desert, a vast space, we see the water. The sun rays becomes hot, and it reflects in the sand. And its reflection makes dilution of water. Its reflection makes dilution of waves in the sand. We can clearly see there the water. Water is flowing. There are waves. Very clear. And slowly, slowly, you can see reflections also there. So how can it learn? There is no region to deny, there is not water. Very clearly, not only you, other persons also have same experience. There may be thousands of thousands of people. Every one will get same experience. Yes, there is water. Mirage. And if you go there, then you experience there is no water. It just appears. In Vedanta, we call it asat. It appears without existence. There is no existence of water. When you go there, there is no any trace of water. No. The sand is dried. Sand is hot. No trace of water. When you go there, there is no water, then water appears far away. This is the mirage. The water appears far away. Where you are, there is no water. But appearance of the water is continue. If you are intelligent, you have understanding, you can understand that, yes, this appears, but there also no water. Here also before I saw the water, but when I reached, there is no water. Same method is applied there also. If you apply your intellect, it becomes calm. Yes, there is no water. It just appears without existence. This is a delusion. This is a mirage. And it becomes quiet. So, a realized person is, we have same. Once he experiences, this is asat. The world is asat. It means everything is asat. Like, the and very scientific way. If we test our blood, we take a drop, single drop of blood, and we understand everything. What is sugar? What is cholesterol? We do not require all blood to examine your body. If you do have sugar or not, one drop is enough. To understand our ocean, one drop of water is enough for intelligent person. But without intelligence, you cannot understand even whole water. It is not possible. So intelligent person, like self-realized person, experience one time and understand every time. Experience only one somewhere and understand everywhere. Asat, Shankaracharya said, asat anatma tattvam vititam maru marichika kalpam, like desert in mirage in desert. So all universe, see the daring of the Shankaracharya. His clear vision, realization, the power of realization. He says, everything like mirage in desert. There is no reality. They don't have any existence. They are asat. If they are asat, then they are not self. Anatma-tattvam. There are no existence, then they are not self. So today we conclude here. Thank you very much. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Vadarayanam Sutra Bhashya Kritau Vande Vantau Punat Punaha Ishvaro Gururatmeti Murti Veda Vibhagine Vyomavadhyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namaha Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.